Good morning and welcome to Chronicle TV. These are your headlines for Monday, June 25th. My name is John.
My name is Alan.
And here's a word from our sponsor.
This has been Ford Country for 25 years, and it will be for 25 more.
Nick Nicholas Ford, Inverness.
Well, a local vet came home to a welcome surprise. Private First Class Michael Pietroburgo actually was signing up at the Hernando VFW post, and a local realtor actually met him with a gift package. The gift package included anything from gift certificates to local restaurants to health clubs, even to a full day of offshore fishing and kayaking. And it's a way for local businesses who donated these gifts to really give back to the vets that are out there serving our country. And it's a great story.
And this has been an effort going on for the last few weeks, trying to collect all these gifts and these items, because there's several young men and women that are going to be coming back into town over the next few weeks, and they want to make sure that they're really welcomed with a true gift, so that they know that they're honored.
And the great thing about this story is that it's actually bringing back the fanfare to when vets come back, and I think it's just something we've all wanted to happen. It's a good thing that Barbara Mills is making it happen. And if you look at the screen right now, you can see a way to actually donate. You can either email Barbara Mills at barbaramills@remax.net, or you can drop off your donations to area businesses like Nick Nicholas Ford, Beef O'Brady, Cinnamon Sticks, and so on. For a complete list, check out on Chronicle Online today.
Very good.
For other news, John?
Well, we also have the EOC is back in the news. It's created a lot of fanfare for other reasons over the last few weeks. But at issue right now is that Joyce Valentino has always been against the expansion, saying that the new EOC is just way too large. They requested a 41,000 square foot emergency operations center. She still feels like it's too large. It's going to be a $16 million project, and right now they need a short-term loan for $14 million, and that's going to be back in the news. This Tuesday's County Commission meeting, actually, we'll have that as an item of discussion, so if you're interested in that, this Tuesday's County Commission meeting is where you want to be.
So some interesting things about this Tuesday is that there's only going to be three commissioners there. Mm-hmm. Commissioner Vicki Phillips is actually going to be out for personal business, and Commissioner Thrumson is going to be traveling the county during Election Day, so keep in mind for Election Day. But something else that's interesting is that right now the EOC is about 4,000 square foot, but it's going to about 41,000, so
correct.
That's a lot of space, and it's pretty heated contention out there, right?
There is, because, on one side of the fence, the Sheriff's Department is saying that they're trying to build for the future and not be short-sighted in the size of the building they produce. They contend that some of the things that the building would offer would be emergency operations, not only for the Sheriff's Department, but for constitutional officers like Supervisor of Elections and so on and so forth would actually have the ability of being in a case-hardened building immediately following a storm. So that's really what's at issue.
It could really address some of our community space needs.
It could.
So in other news, the county and the city of Crystal River is actually opening discussion whether or not to create a sewer district. The issue spans back from a grant that was given to the city of Crystal River to actually bring the sewer lines up to code inside the city and outside. And some of the contested areas are really in Turkey Oak Boulevard, but more specifically out in Fort Island Trail. And some folks are actually saying that the plantation, the city's looking to annex them both for tax purposes and to help out with the sewer. But there's some areas that are kind of getting left out. There's an island around the corner there.
There are. There's a couple issues at stake here. It was a $12 million grant that the city was awarded in 2000. And through the interlocal agreement that already exists, the city is really mandated to be able to provide sewer services within a certain region within just outside the city limits. And so now getting to this island actually would cause a lot of expense. The city wants to do it, but they need some agreement with the county for the funding of it.
Sure. And for more information on the grant, it's actually they would get up to $750,000 every year to go ahead and put these sewer projects in. The problem is the city really wants to do it all at one time.
They do. They feel like they can, leverage the expense of all of this plus, do it all now when it would be less expensive than it would be in the future.
And what the county is looking to do in partnering with the city is to create a sewer district, kind of like in Chazawitzkin and Homosassa, where they would actually tax the residents affected by the new sewer. And County Services Development Director Gary Madoff,
yep,
says the talks are actually, they're optimistic at this time.
Yeah, he seems optimistic that this is something that's going to happen, so I would keep checking back on Chronicle TV and keep checking back in the Chronicle to find out further details on this story as it evolves.
And that's been your headlines. My name is Alan.
And I'm John.
Thanks for joining us.